Hey everyone, it's Jacob with another daily vlog. Somebody asked me a question in the Facebook group that I run. So I have a Facebook group called The Future If. We have around 2,200 people in there, which by the way, you're more than welcome to join, which you can do by going to thefutureif.com. That's thefutureif.com. And it's really a place where we have discussions about all things related to the future. And somebody posted a question in there that I thought I would address here because I responded in the community, but I think it's applicable for everybody. And their question was around what leaders should do during this time of a crisis, or pretty much any crisis for that matter. And I'll share my response to this individual in the community with you. And probably the best, and actually I think I saw somebody shared a link that Simon Sinek did a video, probably it's gonna sound exactly like this one because we talked to the same CEOs, so it'll probably be the same story that he shared. I didn't see his video, but I'm assuming it'll be the same story. And what I shared with him is that the best thing that you can do is just to have open and honest and transparent discussions with your people, because this is not something that a lot of leaders experience. And it's very tempting in a time like this as a leader to just immediately focus on yourself or your organization, to cut costs, to slash jobs, to treat people as being expendable. It's an entire other thing to practice a little bit of empathy, to practice a little bit of being human, and to just talk to your employees and say, guys, look, this is what's going on. I'm not really sure what to do. You know, can we brainstorm an idea together? And my favorite example of this comes from Bob Chapman. And Bob is one of the CEOs that I interviewed for my book. I've had him on my podcast a couple times. I've been on his podcast a few times. And he shares this really interesting story about how, I think it was during the 2008 financial crisis, he's the CEO of a company called Barry Waymiller. They have 12,000 employees there. And he shares this story of how during the financial crisis, his board and a lot of his executive team wanted him to lay off thousands of people. And Bob basically said, I can't do that. You know, I'm the CEO, I'm supposed to look after these people. I can't just let go of them during tough times. And so he had that open and honest and transparent discussion with his people, and he decided to furlough a lot of his employees. And a furlough basically means that you're not fired from the company, but you're taking basically a leave of absence. And so he said, look, we're gonna create this furlough program for our employees. And again, he was very open and honest and transparent with this. And the really cool thing about this is not only did he not fire people, but through this furlough program, I mean, in any company, in any situation, there are some people who are more financially stable and more financially well off than others. And so through this furlough program, what he noticed is that these employees started to help each other out, and they helped each other out in a couple ways. So employees who were more financially well off, they said, you know what, I'm willing to take the furlough longer. Like, I won't work longer so that other people who are less financially well off can work. Give them my hours, give them my time, let them work. I don't need the money as much as they do. And these employees started to come together, 12,000 of them, helping each other out, finding their solution. They would come together to bring supplies and food for each other if they needed it. Like, they really came together as a community, as a company, as a tribe to help each other out. And it wasn't just a leader at the top of the company saying, we're firing people, we're letting people go. I think this is a fantastic story and an example of what you as a leader should do during tough times. Tear down that stereotypical leadership facade. Be open with your people. Admit that you don't necessarily know what to do, and just be honest with them. I have a team of 10 people that I work with, and I'm very honest and transparent with them. And, I'm not laying people off. I'm not telling people not to work. But at the same time, I'm telling them to just be more cost conscientious, right? We're not spending money on ads if we don't need to, or fancy images or stuff like that. And we were coming together to come up with ideas for what we can do to make sure that everybody can still work and get their jobs done. You know, I didn't just send an email to everybody that just says, stop working, like everyone is done for a while. That's not the right approach. So think about how you would want to be treated during these types of tough times as a leader. That's how you should basically treat other people. Be empathetic, try to understand where other people are coming from, and really just have that open and honest and transparent discussion with others. Let them know that you're scared as well, because I'm sure you are as a leader. You know, you probably don't know what to do. You don't have all the right answers. Nobody does. This is not something that we're used to dealing with. So instead of making the decision for your people, what I'm suggesting is make the decision with your people. have everybody come together, brainstorm ideas, and see what can be done, because that is ultimately the best thing that you can do. That is truly what the great leaders do, is practice a little bit of humanity and a little bit of empathy, and I think you'll find that your employees will appreciate it. And after this is all done, you will be a much better leader as a result. Curious to hear what you think. Leave a comment below. Are you seeing this inside of your company? Have you been trying to do anything like this as well? I'd love to hear from you. I always love stories and examples from others. And I hope you're having a wonderful day wherever in the world you are. Stay positive, stay optimistic, and we'll all get through this.